What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. In this video, I've got another very important AMC update to bring all of you this afternoon. So what we're going to be covering in this video is the fact that CITADEL Securities, the market maker, is starting to be investigated by our government and the regulatory institutions in the financial market. So what this is essentially going to do is take away a lot of the ammo that CITADEL and a lot of giant other market makers like them are going to be able to use on retail investors. This is a great step in the right direction, and we're going to go over some of these proposals and how they are affecting AMC and retail investors as a whole. Now, the second thing that we need to go over is the fact that a lot of these over-leveraged hedge funds are starting to liquidate a lot of their positions. There's a very weird dynamic going on right now, and essentially what they're doing is trying to convince retail investors that everything is fine in the broad markets and are trying to dump all of their positions that they need to offload onto retail investors in order to make them bag holders. But again, we are a lot smarter than that, and we know how to position ourselves accordingly from all of the research that we have done over the past 6 months. So before we get into all of that information, if you enjoyed the information and analysis that I provide for you in this video, make sure you go down and hit that like button. It costs you nothing to do it, but it really helps us out a whole lot in getting this information out to as many people who want to learn. And the more people that we have staying up to date on accurate AMC information, the stronger our community becomes. And if you guys want to see more videos like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button. So when we're looking at the chart of AMC today, at the current time that I'm recording, we are trading at about $36.63, down about 1.6% on the day. Now, this is not necessarily what we wanted to see out of AMC going into Friday, but in the past, because there's so many options that are expiring at the end of the week, we do typically see some red days in order to get some of these options out of the money to kind of lessen the burden on the market makers. Now, when we come over to Ortex, at the current time, we have a short interest change today of about 1.52%. Utilization actually jumped up today, meaning that there are more shares out on loan. And we are seeing that kind of reflected on the shares on loan right here. But again, Ortex is not the end all be all of sources. And I've said this a lot in my live streams that I kind of just use Ortex as a baseline for what we could kind of surmise could potentially be the short interest in AMC or any other stock. Now, let's get into these CITADEL investigations. When we come over to the Seeking Alpha article, now, I know a lot of you guys do not like Seeking Alpha. I personally don't really like them either, but you have to be able to differentiate between the FUD articles and the articles that actually have good information. So Democrats seek tougher hedge fund regulation after Robinhood and Archegos debacles. When we come down a little bit further, there are over a dozen proposals under consideration, including banning market makers like CITADEL from paying Robinhood to carry out investor trades and requiring hedge funds to disclose any short selling or similar bets against stocks to the public. So what they're referencing there in the short interest reporting, it seems like they're referencing FINRA 2119, which wants all of the shorts to be reported, even the synthetic shorts. That is a really important proposed rule change. And if that goes into effect, that is going to give a lot more transparency to the market. But again, it is the government, it is these regulatory institutions. So we are going to have to wait and see what is going to happen. But the fact that CITADEL has popped up and not just this Seeking Alpha piece right here and is involved in these different investigations, it means that our regulatory institutions are trying to take steps in the right direction, or they're trying to make it look like they're taking steps in the right direction, so they may not be as liable when all of these situations play out. So when we look at what they're essentially saying here is that the proposal is basically saying, yeah, no more payment for order flow. Now, that's going to take a lot of lobbying and a lot of effort in order to get this passed, but Canada has no payment for order flow, and neither do a lot of countries in Europe. I'm not necessarily sure if it's every single country in Europe, but I do know that the vast majority of brokerages over in Europe do not allow payment for order flow. Now, this is going to basically cause CITADEL to not make as much money. So take that information how you will. I know there's a lot of debate going on about payment for order flow right now, but I'm trying to give you guys the facts of the information that I see. Now, the second thing that CITADEL is being investigated for is antitrust. So we all know that CITADEL is a massive player in the market. Biden's big business crackdown for bad Wall Street behemoths. We can see down here, President Biden's big business crackdown could be bad news for Wall Street titans like Ken Griffin. happen. The controversial order, which Biden could sign as soon as next week, which it has not actually been signed, would seek to bypass traditional antitrust enforcement actions by directing regulators to rethink their rules for their respective industries. What they're seeing here is that Citadel and a lot of these other giant market makers have such a widespread, wild control over our financial markets, and it's not healthy. Now, let's get into these hedge fund liquidations. When we come over here, this is going to be talking about Goldman Sachs' prime brokerage operations. So we've seen a lot from Goldman Sachs over the past couple of weeks. Them themselves have actually liquidated about 25% of their equity positions and have dumped all of those positions onto retail investors. So those people who are continuously supplying the bids in these stocks are essentially allowing Goldman Sachs and eventually a lot of these other institutions to basically get out of their position scot-free and basically take their gains. So we can see here that on Tuesday, the Goldman Sachs prime brokerage book saw the largest one-day net selling since June 17th. This defensive positioning has continued through much of the post-Monday rally. So when we come down a little bit further, single names saw the largest one-day selling. 8 out of 11 sectors were net sold, led in dollar terms by healthcare, industrials, consumer, and utilities. Now, they're buying stay at home, so this could suggest that a lot of these different hedge funds or institutions are getting worried that there could be another shutdown. They're buying software and they're going risk off in tech. Now, when we pull up this chart that they have down here, I want to make sure this is bigger for you guys. This is the most important section right here. This is the trading flow in US equities. So this black line right here is showing the net flow, and it's going to be long or short. So in April going into May, we saw a decline. We are going from net long to net short. We saw an uptrend back in June into July, and we are now seeing a downtrend going into the net short territory. So essentially, what we're seeing here is that a lot of these institutions are repositioning themselves to the downside. Now, think about this for a second. A lot of these institutions are seeing what is going on, and there's a massive market event coming in the near future. It could be due to interest rate hikes. It could be due to inflation. It could be due to the over-leveraging. There are so many different things going on in our markets right now, but the key factor is that everything is pointing to a downtrend. So think about this for a second. Goldman Sachs has already started liquidating their positions. Now, there's Morgan Stanley, there's Citigroup, there's Credit Suisse. There's a lot of other institutions that are thinking in very similar terms. So what would you do in order to dump your position if you don't want to actually flood the market with selling volume and basically receive lower sale prices on the sold positions? What would you do? You would go to the dark pool. So dark pools have limited market impact, and essentially you can not impact the market, get better fill orders, and kind of put everything under the rug. But the problem is that if you are an institution, the only other counterparties that can trade in these dark pools are other institutions who are going to have the same idea as you. So you can't really use the dark pools when this situation ends up starting to really pick up, because everybody is going to have the same idea and is going to want to sell off. So what they're going to have to do is kind of pump up all of retail sentiment in order for them to keep supplying the bids, in order for them to slowly sell off their positions. Now, what this is going to eventually do is create a slow bleed down in the markets while they're pumping these ETFs. And we can confirm that that is happening when we come over here. We can see that how bad is the breadth? According to Morgan Stanley strategists, over the last month, it's the weakest we have ever seen. With the S&P 500 making new all-time highs, more specifically, there are more stocks making new 52-week lows than highs when looking at the broad universe of stocks in the U.S. market. This would suggest that a lot of these institutions are starting to get out of their positions because they know something is coming. So here is how we get this back to AMC. I know we talked about a lot of broad market stuff in this video, and I want you guys to understand the implications of these significant sell-offs. So we know that all of these institutions are going to try to dump the bag on retail and get out scot-free when this situation ends up coming to fruition. The problem is that if they cannot get their positions offloaded quick enough, they're going to be taking significant losses, meaning that they're going to be continuously getting margin called, margin called, margin called, and are going to need to generate the liquidity in order to meet those those margin requirements. If eventually they cannot meet those margin requirements, they are going to get forcefully liquidated from a lot of their positions. This drains the liquidity of institutions and puts the potential for short covering on these wildly over-leveraged positions on AMC and GameStop so much higher. So in my opinion, we are in the driver's seat for this AMC GameStop short squeeze situation, and it is really a waiting game at the current time. I've said this a couple of times in my other videos that the only thing that has changed in this short squeeze play on AMC and GameStop is the price that we are seeing on the screen. We know we're going to see lots of manipulation, and we 100% know that we're going to be seeing a lot of volatility. In my opinion, it's best to try to keep the emotions at a minimum and just keep pushing along, have the plan that you have set out for yourself in the back of your head, and stick to it. Nobody should be able to come in and tell you what to do with your money or where to place it. So that is going to conclude this update on AMC. If you enjoyed the information and analysis that I provided for you in this video, make sure you go down and hit that like button. It costs you nothing to do it, but it really helps us out a whole lot in getting this information out to as many people who want to learn. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell so you're notified every time I post a new video, so you get to stay up to date on all of your favorite stocks, learn about a couple of new ones, and see exactly which options I am trading and which strategies I am using to trade them. So I hope you guys are having a great day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.